Hello students of 7th standard. We have started the lesson number 6, measurement of physical quantities from your science textbook. So today we are going to see page number 43. See what is there given in this on this page. There are some new points which are related with the physical quantities. So that we are going to learn. The quantities are nothing but the fundamental quantities, and you can say also the international system of units is that standards of the fundamental quantities. So various quantities we are going to learn in this on this page. So what is there? See, there are different physical quantities, but measurement of them are related. See, to each other. For example, you have learned the quantity of the speed. The speed we give as distance upon time. So next, see there, try this. Work out the area of your classroom. Which quantities are given or which quantities are taken on account to calculate the area. Therefore, if whenever you are going to calculate the area of your classroom, you are going to count its length and breadth. So these are also one of the, you can say, one of the physical quantities that we are going to measure. The next one we are going to see is nothing but the fundamental quantity. It is enough to select a few out of many quantities and standardize their units. See, whatever the units are there are many units, but to get the quantities of many, you can say, physical quantities, we have to standardize their unit. You can see from the above example that the units of the quantities are nothing but length and time, needed to be standardized. Such quantities are called as a fundamental quantities. So these quantities are called as a fundamental quantities, and their units, whatever the physical quantities are there, their units are called as a standard units. That means whenever you want to measure the length, you are going to measure it into the meters. So this is nothing but one of the standardized unit of that length. Of course, a standard fundamental unit must be available to all, and it must not be variable. Whenever you are considering the physical quantities, so it should contain this, you can say, a specific unit. There should not be variability into this units. Then see next one, international system of units. Our international system of units is based on the, you can say, 7 fundamental units called the system international. So what it is called? It is called as a system international, or you can say SI. Then see, is currently used all over the world. It is also called as a metric system. See, the names and the symbols, whenever you consider the name and the symbols of the units, then see, there should be fundamental quantities also. The length, the time, the mass in this system are given in the following table. Whenever you see, the table is given here, quantities are given here. See here, whenever you want to measure the length, the unit that you use is nothing but a meter, and the symbol of the unit is given as M. Whenever you want to measure the mass, the quantity mass, it is given, the unit is given as kilograms, and the symbol of the unit is nothing but kg. Whenever the time, quantity time, you are going to express, in the units, that is nothing but the seconds, and symbol of the unit, that is nothing but the S. So this way you are having the, you can say, various units for the various physical quantities. Now see next one, standards of the fundamental quantities. Whenever you are seeing the standards of the fundamental quantities, you have to know the fundamental quantities very well. See, as a standard of a mass, a solid cylinder made of a platinum, iridium alloy is kept in the International Bureau of Weights and Measure at Paris. Or you can say, if we want to measure a particular physical quantity, there should be only one, you can say, unit, or there should be only one weight. So to know this, there is an International Bureau of Weights and the measurements are kept at the, you can say, Paris. As per international agreement, this mass is called as a 1 kilogram. Means that means there is a, you can say, standardized mass, and this mass is considered as 1 kilogram, which is kept in the Bureau or International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Paris. Where it is kept? It is kept in the Paris. It has the, it is nothing but one of the standardized unit. Then see, official accurate copies of the prototype are kept in the standardizing laboratories, institutes all over the world. Whenever you see, in all over the world, there are laboratories and there are institutes, and in these institutes the accurate, you can say, measurements are kept there, so that you can understand which are the, you can say, physical quantities and what is their accurate measurement. The two fine lines are engraved on the platinum iridium bar kept in the International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Paris. So what is there? See, a platinum iridium bar is taken, and in that two fine lines are, you can say, engraved. Engraved means carved. They are carved there, and these are present at the International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Paris. The distance between these two lines is accepted as a, you can say, standard meter. Whenever you want to measure the meter, then what it is done? The distance between these two lines is measured, or it is taken as a, you can say, 1 meter. Accurate copies are, you can say, or accurate copies are distributed to standardizing laboratories, institutes all over the world. So what is this measurement? According to this measurement, all the measurements are, you can say, given to the laboratories, or you can say the institutes, which are all over the world, and they have to accept whatever the distance is present between the two lines is nothing but a 1 meter. It is taken to be an 1 meter. The time required for one revolution of Earth is measured by means of accurate device. See, whenever you want to see the time which is used to measure the revolution of the Earth, that is also, you can say, measured through an accurate device. Now see, the time is taken to be as 24 hours. That means a day and a night is of, you can say, total it is of 24 hours. That means day is of 12 hours and night is of 12 hours. Together we take it as a 24 hours. The standardized 1 second, 1 hour is considered to be, see, 60 minutes. That means 1 hour. Whenever you want to measure 1 hour, 1 hour is taken to be as a 60 minutes. Then see, 1 minute contains 60 seconds and 1 hour contains 60 minutes. So this is one of the, you can say, standardized unit taken by the Bureau. Then see, next page. Identify the wrong methods of measurement shown in the picture and explain why they are wrong. See, whenever you are going to take the actual measurement of any cloth, or you can say of any distance, you can't take it with the hand span. As we have discussed below, before, what we have discussed, that the hand span measurement of different peoples will be different, so therefore the measurement may vary, and therefore we can't use the, you can say, hand span to measure the distance. Similarly, whenever you are going to measure the you can say water or any liquid matter, so what it should contain, it should contain one standardized unit. That means a particular instrument should be there so that it could measure 1 liter, or you can say 500 milliliters. This way it should measure. So there should be no any, you can say, supposed any system for that. That means this vessel is of, you can say, 1 liter, like that it should not be there. There should be one of the, you can say, standardized unit for that. The importance of the accurate measurement. However, whenever you see that the measurement depends upon all these purposes, accordingly, see, an appropriate device has to be used for the measurement. Whenever you are measuring a particular, you can say, any of the object, that time the appropriate, you can say, devices should be used so that you can measure the, you can say, any substance. Measurement of the substance that are previous of great importance and used in an very small quantities. The measurement of the substances whichever are used in a small quantities is very, you can say, important. For example, whenever you are measuring the gold, little difference may cause the heavy loss. So this is most important that you should weigh the, you can say, gold very accurately. Then see, due to advancement in the technology, devices that measure very small magnitudes of the quantities like distance, mass, time and temperature are available. For example, distance and time in connection with every important sports competition, mass of a gold, body temperature. See, whatever we are measuring is most important here. Whenever you are measuring the gold, or you can say the mass of the gold, it is very important that you have to measure it accurately. Whenever you are doing the sports competition, the distance and the time is most important. Then body temperature, whenever you are seeing the degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit, is most important. Then see, major causes of the errors in the measurement. If you are not using a proper device, you may have a error there. Not using the device properly, then also you will have a error there. So you have to make a list of possible errors that are there. Do you really get many liters of a petrol as the petrol pump indicates? To ensure this is necessary to check it against a standard measure from a time to time. This is called as a standardization. So whenever you are going to a petrol pump, what you are doing? You are seeing first whether the point starts from zero or no. Otherwise, you may get a wrong measurement there. And whenever this measurement goes wrong, what happens? You will get a less petrol. So, to avoid this, what you are doing? You are getting, you are starting it from zero. And up till how much petrol you want, you are setting the timing there. Then see, similarly, it is necessary to standardize the weights and measures used in the market also. In market also, there are various, you can say, measures and weights are there. That also you want to standardize. Then see, while buying the things at the grocery shops, the vegetable market, remember to look out for the following and tell your guardian to do so. Whenever you are going to a market and you are buying something, you have to see whether the standardized, you can say, weights are used or no. Does the balance carry the stamp of the standardization by the departments of weights and measures? That also you want to see. Is the balance stable whenever you are weighing? That is also most important. Then whether the pointer becomes steady or no, that also you want to see. Whenever you are weighing a metal, then how the balance should be held? It should be held accurately and the pointer should be exactly at the middle. So you have to see whether inside of the pan there is any temperature or any another metal is fixed so that the weight should be more. So all these things you have to see to prevent consumers from being cheated. So weights and major subdivision functions at the part of the food, urban supply and consumer protection division of the government. Officers of this subdivision visit different places. So there are officers who are visiting the different places and they are observing the, you can say, the measurements. So this should be done every year. So see, the at time to time there should be, you can say, weights and balance should be measured or should be seen. It is a binding by a law to use standardized weights and measures. That it is most important that you have to use the standardized, you can say, weights and measure. So it is also a function of the weights and measures subdivision to grant the license. You should have the license for using these types of a measurements, and there should be always repairing of the weights and measures.